We are in the Niagara Gorge Discovery Center, celebrating the launch of our project tomorrow, and there really couldn't be a more perfect place because we can look out the window and see Niagara Falls. And I think that's one of the amazing things about the Niagara Gorge. We want the whole world to know that the gorge is one of the best imaginable windows on Niagara Falls.
Okay, we're coming after the invasive species because this is one of the most biologically diverse areas on this planet. 80% of all plant species in Niagara, Buffalo Niagara region are found right here in the gorge. And it's just incredible what's gone on. Over 300, I had to see this twice, 300 bird species, putting it on par with places like the Everglades and the Galapagos. I don't think people realize what we have right here. So I don't need to tell you. You know that this is a majestic jewel. It needs to be polished every once in a while because the invasive species have taken hold. And if we did not take action now, the erosion would continue and the loss of the natural habitat for these animals and birds would be devastated. So we are coming after them. And what it takes, of course, is money. And the Land Conservancy, with the assistance of the state of New York, is going to begin on-the-ground ecological restoration work that includes invasive species control, planting native trees, shrubbery, grass, flowers, also butterflies and more public access down to the gorge, making new connections. And this is funded in part by the Buffalo Billion. So we are realizing that if we don't put the money here now, we will pay later. And that's why this is a smart investment. So what's going to happen is with the money, we're going to be able to remove invasive species and restore 125 acres right here. That's incredible. $2.1 million project. Has $1 million from the Niagara River Greenway Commission, Ecological Committee, another $1 million from the Buffalo Billion, and a $100,000 grant from the Oath Community Benefit Fund for Niagara County. So this is why we are so excited today, because this is the beginning of taking back our gorge. Restore the gorge is our mantra.
We who live here at Niagara Falls understand that the gorge is, in many ways, as great a resource as the falls itself. We had great faith in the power of Mother Nature, and we felt that if we could just get the road removed, Mother Nature would take care of the rest, and the environment would restore itself in some way, shape, or form, and we'd see a Mother Nature reclaim in some way, shape, or form industrial lands, for example, that had gone into disuse or other areas. And you know, we had this faith that if you took out the concrete infrastructure, eventually something green would grow there, probably sooner rather than later. What we didn't understand, I think, or we just didn't think about very much because we were so caught up in the politics of the parkway issue, was that the plants that grow in disturbed spaces are not usually the native plants that were there before the space was disturbed. Well, it's, you know, we now know that if we take out concrete, something will grow there, but what grows in disturbed spaces? Invasives, right? That's why they're invasive. They're opportunistic plants that take over places where nothing else is growing. So in this case, if we want to have a restored Niagara Gorge, we've got to give Mother Nature a little bit of an assist. And that's exactly what this program aims to do. I think that this is a project that is very, very important. It has economic significance to our tourism economy, but I think it's even more important because it shows that our concern for the environment isn't just about us and our lifetimes, but that we're concerned about the world that our kids and our grandkids are going to live in. This is truly a gift to the world.
I think one of the most important aspects of this particular project is this parkway goes out, it gets a lot of attention about restoring this land to natural beauty and parkland along the top of the gorge, and also the 125 acres down inside the gorge it'll be restored. But on top up here, especially down in the area near DeVoe, where Whirlpool Street is very close to the homes, that whole area there is going to be restored, and out front of their homes in the neighborhood there is going to be beautiful parkland that the Land Conservancy, along with its landscape architect Daryl Morrison, are working on to create an environment there where those homes will have a beautiful front area in front of them between them and the gorge, instead of just an overgrowth area that's there right now. This is all really important. It's important to the community. It's important the gorge restoration, the ecology, you name it, on any front, it's really important. Those touches are part of what's going into our parkway removal project, but it's really about creating parkland where it's been a highway.
I'm confident that this revitalized Niagara Gorge will be important to not only the quality of life of our residents of Niagara Falls in our region, but the 9 million visitors who come each year. So our crews begin work tomorrow morning, so it's the perfect time for all of us to celebrate the evolving and important stories of the Niagara Gorge. Today I want to officially launch the 8421 Club. I see that many of you are sporting our buttons. So 84% of the surface freshwater of North America is in our Great Lakes, flowing through our Great Lakes, and that is 21% of the world's surface freshwater. So the magic of Niagara Falls is not just a story of its breathtaking beauty, but also it's a place to reflect on the importance to our entire world of taking care of our water. It's a vital natural resource that'll become even more important in the world in the years ahead. And water quality is kind of all about the edges between the land and the water, and the Niagara Gorge has a lot of edges. So thanks to funding from the Buffalo Billion II and the Niagara River Greenway, and the Oath Community Benefit Fund for Niagara County, the Land Conservancy's work in the gorge will strengthen the rich and complex fabric of life on the edges on our Niagara Gorge.